topaka boholwa mudimo.
I am here to testify about the goodness of God, the greatness of God.
Semudiman ketsedi sensona maoban.
What God has done for me yesterday.
Kerata Psalm 23, erin hanka zama kholo nyam ritualifu.
I love Psalm 23 that says, even though I walk in the shadow of death.
Ngekeveka tswali thoba onalin.
I will not be afraid, for he is with me.
Maobani kileka tswaro kishlo late afternoon.
Yesterday I had a headache late in the afternoon.
Maybe hanka robala hanyani itlaba ngon.
And then I thought maybe if I could sleep a little, then it will be better.
Then karobala, haki robala.
When I slept.
Ki haki lora kotorong ki tswari kishlo hebele mashwaka le reti honali something.
I had a dream where I felt I had a headache and there was something at the back of my neck.
Then haki papa ma kitoma kirapel.
So when I woke up, I started praying.
Kiribuka that spirit.
I rebuked that spirit.
Then after a few minutes, shock hands were serious.
After a few minutes, the headache became worse.
And yaba worse ha hulu kabaka tuake phone la banabesu.
It became so worse that I had to phone my brothers.
Kabaka phone la le pastor.
I even phoned my pastor.
Then pastor rapela lena.
Pastor prayed with me over the phone.
And immediately hakata rapela lena, shock had disappeared.
Immediately the pastor finished praying for me, the headache was gone.
Then halte ke kisekele right ne sekele right ka baka lo katswela pele ka phe halte ke tshela dijo ke tshela bana dijo.
I became okay, and I even cooked, and as I was giving my children food,
ho fihla something so heavy ya fihla dula ya ka idula ko ho nna mahetleng le pelong.
I felt something heavy over my shoulders and even in my heart.
Ya ka like ya ka bophelo baka, that's it, bufetse.
I felt like my life was over.
Then
when I sat down, I felt something saying, I must give up because I'm dying. I stood up and started screaming. I refused and I rebuked the spirit of death. I shouted in the house so much so that my husband came to see what was wrong. I could not move my legs nor my shoulders. We all prayed, even my siblings prayed with me.
Until that thing even
until this heaviness left me. I could see that the devil wanted to take my life yesterday. But God protected me. He said, even though I walk in the valley of the shadow of death, he is with me.
He's always there with me.
I know that in every battle that I'm facing, udula ana le nna. I would like to say thank you, my Father, for the prayers yesterday. May God bless you and may He add in what you have already have. Thank
you.
I'm here to thank His greatness for Him to take care of me until today. I'm here to praise the Lord. Here in the church. I started coming to this church last year. I had my problems when I came here. And even children's problem. But when I entered this church, God separated. I have my first child. The child failed twice in standard 9. My parents worship at Zion. So they worship ancestors. They would say we need this and that. But when I came to this church, my child passed. Since the child has passed, the child was in grade 12. She passed very well. I am here to just thank the Lord. Even to the brethren who were coming to worship with us in
Tafelkop.
I And I would like to thank God because he has changed our life. We as now, anyone can see that we are Christians now. Another thing that I would like to talk about. My child was pregnant. I spoke about this child to say that she lives in Venda. And she was not well. In Venda, they sent us here.
And then,
this child became pregnant. I did not have hope. But by bringing her here and keep on praying, God has blessed us a lot. She gave birth on the
23rd.
I did not have hope because of the situation that she was in. People were always saying, a person who has this kind of problem never gives birth naturally or successfully. So when she phoned me to say that she had a stomach ache, I told her to pray when she gets home.
And then
I advised her to tell the people that she was visiting that she was not feeling well, she had a stomach ache. They took her to hospital. She stayed the whole night in the hospital and then she phoned to say that I'm in hospital, please pray for me. And she gave birth.
Though
I believe in God's wonders, I doubted that because of the pregnancy she will be successful. But God has shown me his power. Even if you are feeling hopeless, know that God is here. Whatever challenges or problems that you are facing, God can resolve them. I thank God and I thank the pastors who are always encouraging us to pray. And I'm also grateful for the people who are coming for prayers where we are living, we're staying. We still need them so that our things can be in order.